Why did Sir Francis Dashwood, the first baronet, build the new Dashwood House at another location on his estate, when he could have built at the existing location? The position of Dashwood House gives it an isolated feel, as if it were on the periphery, or outskirts, of something. If an artificial tunnel was going to be constructed, to connect Dashwood House to the caves, then it would have made more sense to build Dashwood House closer to the caves. A shorter tunnel would have been cheaper and easier to build, and quicker to traverse when complete. If we assume that there is a tunnel linking Dashwood House to the caves, and that it existed prior to the house's construction, then the house's peculiar position suggests it was purposefully built over the tunnel's entrance. The new Dashwood House needn't have been built directly over the proposed tunnel opening. It may have been built very near it, or had an ancillary building constructed on top of it. The design of the Dashwood Mausoleum is atypical. A normal mausoleum would consist of an enclosed structure, with a ground-level sarcophagus at its center, and perhaps additional sarcophagi close by. Access to the interior would be restricted, and it would not be possible for people to see inside. The Dashwood Mausoleum is open air, and fully exposed to the elements. Its central cenotaph houses no human remains, and its ash-containing urns are mounted high up in its structure. Access to the interior is controlled by the Dashwood family, but the public can see inside, and read some of the inscriptions. Dashwood chose to build the mausoleum, over half a kilometer away from Dashwood House, on West Wickham Hill. This placed it directly above the caves, and in perfect alignment with the newly constructed West Wickham Road. If the mausoleum's purpose was to provide a final resting place for members of the Dashwood family, and a means by which to remember them, then why wasn't it built in a more secluded area closer to Dashwood House? Why doesn't the mausoleum face Dashwood House or West Wickham Village? The points made here, and previously, suggest that the Dashwood Mausoleum has another function outside of a resting place for the dead. There may well have been an occult, or ritualistic reason for placing the remains of Dashwood family members inside the mausoleum, especially when one considers that it has been built on top of an earth energy point. Why were human bones discovered during the mausoleum's restoration? The workman in the World VHS video says part of a pelvis was found inside the structure close to the second baronet's headstone. If the second baronet's remains are supposed to be buried in the vault beneath St. Lawrence Church, then whose pelvis was this, and how did it get there? Whose arm bone was found inside the masonry on the south side of the mausoleum, and why were there no external markings or inscriptions to identify it? Was there a reason for a person, or persons, to clandestinely embed human remains into the structure, presumably during its construction? The 11th Baronet says in his book that there was no evidence the Hellfire Club met regularly in the caves.
It is inconceivable that the members of this exclusive society, bound by laws of secrecy and accustomed to comfort and luxury, would have resorted to a place with the entrance in full view of a public road, and in damp, chilly surroundings. I have no doubt, however, that Sir Francis used the caves for occasional parties, just as I have done myself.
If this is so, then why is there a plaque near the inner temple, referencing the activities of the Hellfire Club at the banqueting hall, and the inner temple? The author agrees with the 11th Baronet, as he has visited the Hellfire Caves on at least three occasions. They are cold, cramped, claustrophobic, dark, damp and dirty, and definitely not the type of place any group of people would want to socialize in. Among others, the 11th Baronet cites Medenham Abbey as the club's prime meeting location. If the caves were not developed by Dashwood for Hellfire Club meetings, then what were they developed for, outside of a chalk supply for local roads? The 11th Baronet feels that the cave design was a folly, as was the fashion of the day. But why install a folly deep inside a hill, especially a folly with occult design influences? Over the course of time, how did the Brotherhood of St. Francis of Wickham, whose meeting place was Medenham Abbey, transformed to the Hellfire Club, whose meeting place was the Hellfire Caves? It would seem that the commonly known story of the Hellfire Club, its activities and its meeting location, constitute a false narrative. The Hellfire Club consisted of prominent men like Sir Francis Dashwood, who was the Chancellor of the Exchequer, John Montague, who was the First Lord of the Admiralty, John Wilkes, who was the Lord Mayor of London, and Sir Henry Van Zittart, who was the Governor of Bengal. The author suspects that during the time of the Hellfire Club, the caves could have been used for governmental, and/or military operations, and not just intelligence gathering operations by Dashwood. The conspiratorial plotting may not have been conceived, and/or instigated by Dashwood. It is more likely that he played a smaller role in someone else's larger plan, perhaps to the extent that he merely provided the venue, and hosted its proceedings. If Dashwood was a practitioner of the Eleusinian mysteries, then he could have used its shamanic practices for his own personal development, or for intelligence gathering operations, in much the same way Dr. John Dee used his scrying mirror, or the American military used remote viewing. Was this the reason why Dashwood kept quiet about the Eleusinian mysteries? Was his practice of them part of a governmental operation that had to be kept secret? The author has found no reference to Dashwood specifically giving the name, River Styx, to the stream in the caves. That he did so, appears to be an assumption, or an inference, held by those who have an interest in such matters. If we assume Dashwood did choose the name, it is a good indication that Greek mythology was of importance to him, perhaps the Eleusinian mysteries specifically. There may have already been a natural ley line running between West Wycombe Hill and High Wycombe, in which case the new West Wycombe Road was an enhancement, or an overlay, on the existing natural line. In other words, Dashwood capitalized on an already pre-existing geomantic feature, for his own advantage. The negative entity that Dashwood and his entourage created, could have been an egregore, or a tulpa. The author does not believe that he, or any of his associates, were consciously responsible for bringing this negative entity into existence. For him to have done so deliberately, seems inconsistent with his character, and probably inconsistent with the character of his associates. Perhaps their activities in the caves attracted its attention, or perhaps they unintentionally awakened something that had previously been dormant, or perhaps it was inadvertently or unconsciously created. However, as West Wycombe Road was Dashwood's project, the death symbology and morbid atmosphere along its path does imply a Dashwood connection, but doesn't prove it. The caves have almost definitely been in use long before Dashwood's time, and probably long after it. The caves could have been sealed for at least three reasons: 1, to conceal evidence of governmental operations, or 2, to conceal Dashwood's occult activities, or 3, for safety reasons. The work done to seal off parts of the caves must have been commissioned, or known about, by members of the Dashwood family. Although significant parts of the caves are almost definitely sealed off from public access, in theory, those sealed off areas could be accessed using the secret tunnels. In Part 1, visit Buckinghamshire.org, mentions the Dashwood family vault beneath St. Lawrence Church. Perhaps there is access to the caves from somewhere in that vault. This could explain the 22 steps poem, and the reason for sealing the tunnel, that being, the requirement for privacy, and respect for the dead. Another place to enter the caves, could be the parish church in High Wycombe. To date, the author only has circumstantial evidence and hearsay concerning these secret passages, to the best of his knowledge, no hard evidence of them exists. The J. Bond Stone synchronicity at 26-18 West Wycombe Road tells us very clearly that Dashwood's intelligence operations were the most significant aspect of the caves. There is a lot of death and afterlife symbolism on the mausoleum line, which could have been generated from the practice of Eleusinian rites in the caves, but it's not as clear-cut as the intelligence aspect. One could argue that the death theme and dark atmosphere on the mausoleum line could be the product of negative occult practices that were not in any way connected with the activities of the second Dashwood Baronet. The author is not aware of the existence of any original plans or schematics relating to the cave's development, any witness reports from Dashwood's employees who were involved in the cave's development, or any documentation relating to the financial aspects of the cave's development. The construction of West Wickham Road was supposed to be a significant engineering achievement for its time, yet there appears to be no publicly available information documenting things like the names of the surveyors and laborers who worked on the project, and their rates of pay. Dashwood was keen to publicly state the reason for building the road as a means to relieve local unemployment, but he did not mention any other aspect of the project. Some of the plans for the monuments on the Dashwood estate are on public display in Dashwood House, and documentation pertaining to the Hellfire Club has been made available for public consumption, some of it by the Dashwood family. Such documentation includes an extract from the club's cellar book on display in the caves, at least two club membership lists in public circulation, witness reports from club members themselves, and accounts of the club's activities from non-members. Why aren't the names of the engineers who excavated the caves and built the new West Wickham Road on public display inside the caves? Why is there an apparent information blackout around the cave excavation operation and the construction of West Wickham Road?
Thank you.